Good morning, everybody. Thank you for coming this morning and welcome. So this is the first QRS 5 session of this of the conference. So I have to admit that when I first read QRS 5, I was like, well, fast and furious. I have to do one of those. But, you know, while working through this presentation, I realized that my teaching is the opposite of fast and furious. It's more like slow and serious. So here is my 5 minutes on what I've learned on, you know, after teaching organic chemistry mainly for 1 year. So to you know, in terms of what I'm trying to achieve this morning, okay, let me see how I screen through this. Right, my goal today is an attempt to articulate what I learned, you know, during this year of online teaching. Or, you know, we aspired at the beginning of the pandemic, we aspired to teach online, but I think midway we realized that what we were doing was remote emergency teaching. So I think it was renamed during the pandemic. Now, to give you a little bit of context with regards to the courses that I teach and, you know, the lessons that I learned came from these courses: Introduction to Organic Chemistry and its follow-up, Organic Chemistry 2. These are mainly second year courses. And I taught these courses during the pandemic 3 times. The first offering was summer 2020. That was the first time that course was offered, like the first time offered during summer. So we expected around, you know, 40 people to take it. And we ended up with 120 students. Fall 2020, was its typical 450 students, followed by winter with 350 students. So my first lessons on online teaching, they all happened during the summer 2020. And, you know, taking it from there, I tried to improve the offerings of the other courses. So in terms of the course design or the course delivery, the structure of the courses was very similar. So before COVID, all of these courses, they had face-to-face classes, tutorials, office hours. We had weekly open book online quizzes, 2 midterms and 1 final exam. Most of the, you know, the bulk of the grade came from the midterms and the final exam, almost 80% of the grade. So when I moved to online teaching, like on, you know, with the advent of COVID, I tried to maintain some of that structure. So I ended up doing synchronous classes, tutorials, and office hours, all via Zoom. The classes were recorded, but not the tutorials or the office hours. We kept the weekly online quizzes and, you know, all the online teaching best practices recommended often assessments with low stakes. So I took some of the weight associated with the midterms and the final exam, and I moved that into bi-weekly assignments and a weekly forum discussion question. So I have there 3 to 5 assignments, because I started with 5 assignments and I ended up with 3 based on student feedback. Like, students said that there were too many assessments happening throughout the semester. Now, in terms of the lessons that I learned, I learned how to record videos. I mean, I'm not very, you know, social media oriented, but I had to learn how to do that. I learned how to edit a video, mostly because I had to remove the cat noises from the background of my lecture recordings. I learned how to use Zoom. And in September 2020, the university decided to move from Moodle to Brightspace as their learning management system. I had to learn how to deal with that. And, you know, these are all course tools, tools that are used to improve the experience of the student in the course. But I had to learn a lot of administration related issues. And I think the most unpleasant was dealing with academic integrity violations. And, you know, I had to learn how to look, you know, for those violations online. I had to learn how to compile the information and how to deal with the process of working through those. And I, you know, this is a furious aspect of my Furious 5. I learned that the workload associated with delivering these courses online was very heavy. And in terms of, you know, what I'm going to take, I'm going to take all the resources that I developed during this, during online delivery, especially explanatory videos and forums. I'm going to keep those. I'm going to keep Zoom office hours because I found them well, you know, way better attended than in person. And I think it has to do with the fact that I do not ask the students to turn their cameras on so they can come in, they can, you know, ask their questions in the chat or verbally if they prefer. So I think that they like the, you know, the privacy associated with this online office hours. And I want to keep the Zoom tutorials, and I wasn't sure how to best do that because the students, they have tutorial sections embedded in their schedule. But Marco's talk earlier, I think it gave me this idea of having them maybe, you know, after hours. So, you know, these are the lessons that I learned. I don't know if I'm up to my 5 minutes, but I'm trying really hard not to go past my 5 minutes. So
your 5 minutes are up. So if you want to wrap it up quickly.
This is it. So thank you very much. So this, you know, we can talk later if you have questions.